Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Nabiyyina Muhammad. Brother, sorry, I was in mute. So today we will be discussing about Sheikh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda rahmatullah's the book, last chapter of the book, and it has matched with the current lockdown scenario. And then inshallah we'll be closing it, the book, today. And this chapter deals with the condolence, and as we know, in our life there is some ups and downs. Every time there are some good times and some bad time, and these things happens is quite frequently, and it is common with everyone's life. There is no one in exception in this scenario. So then Sheikh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda rahimahullah, he has mentioned how we should say about the bad news. Shall we say like suddenly, shall we pass the message, or we should keep it in a mild way? So for example, if someone has passed away, then we may say like this, that recently I came to know that Mr. X was ill, and today I came to know that he has passed away. So if we say over a phone or someone seeing, and then suddenly saying, do you know who died? And then he will be shocked, right? So we should keep it in a softened way, and we should give these less. We should try to lessen the impact of this message to the one who is listening to it. Secondly, expressing a condolence is a courtesy and it is a duty. Okay, so if someone has passed away or someone has lost his near one, then it is our duty that we should say our condolence and then tell him about that. This is life. This is part of everyone's life. So Sheikh has mentioned that this is a rule of Allah's creation. So we should understand that we should keep the condolence and give the condolence with others as much as possible in a good way, so that he is feeling a bit relieved. Hafiz ibn al-Mundhiri rahimahullah, he said, love whoever you will and you will part, means you will go distant, you will go away from him. Love whoever you want. Okay, no problem in loving. The rule is everyone should be passing away. Another poet, he is a poet in Arabic language, he said, 8 stages we all must go through. Okay, so he said, happiness and sorrow, two things contrary with each other, opposite of each other, happiness and sorrow, gathering and parting, gathering together and departing. Okay, maybe we come close, maybe we go far. Everyone should go in this. Everyone's life has these things. So he is saying happiness and sorrow, gathering and departing or parting, difficulties and easiness, illness and good health. These 8 things, everyone's life will have these 8 things. Another poet, he said, make perseverance your friend, or perseverance means to be patient. Make perseverance your friend and leave painful sorrow. You are not alone. Everyone lost and will lose a loved one. So everyone has lost loved one, and everyone will lose loved one. If someone is losing his loved one, it means actually it is not affecting only him. It happens with everyone. So if someone is passing away, then we should go to his relative's house and give him condolence, call over phone, send him email or some other things in a correct way, and convey the condolence. So I'm mentioning the hadith that says Muslim owes his Muslim brother 5 rights. Okay, so returning the greeting when he gives salam, he should be wa alaikum salam. Visiting the ill, if he is ill, I should go and visit him, and if he passes away, then I should go and attend his janaza. These are the 5. There are some other things which is not mentioned. I guess it was when he invites in your house, then I should be, or someone who is invited, he should respond it and he should accept the invitation. So these are the rights of Muslim. Another narration of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, visit the sick, and follow the procession. Procession means in Bangla we can say the meet after janaza, who is someone is carrying the janaza, and then people follow that one. So that gathering can be called as a procession of the funeral. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say that visit the sick and follow the procession of funerals. It will give you remembrance of the hereafter. Nearmost meaning of the hadith is like this, okay? And condolence, whenever we are giving condolences, then this is actually elevate the sense of grieving that confront the family of the deceased, meaning that it gives them it gives them motivation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that, and give glad tidings to those who patiently persevere, who is making sabr. Okay, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. When they are afflicted, with any type of disaster, they say, truly we belong to Allah and to Him we will return. Okay, they say, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Whenever they are afflicted with any kind of calamity, any kind of disaster, they say these things. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has praised those people who become perseverance, who make sabr. Okay, so these are the things that is regarding giving condolence is a duty. And I will conclude this subsection with the hadith narrated by Ibn Majah and Bayhaqi rahimahumullah. They have narrated this hadith with a fair authority, means this hadith is authentic. It says that a Muslim who consoles other Muslims suffering from a calamity, he will be rewarded a dress of dignity by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. If I give condolence to my Muslim brother, Allah will give me a dress in the day of judgment, that is dress of dignity. So this is the hadith and reward regarding the reward, why we should do the condolence. Now, we will have two subsections left. It would be a bit long today. Forgive me for being a bit longer. Then this subsection says expressing how we should say and express the condolence. That previous section talked about why we should do that. Now it gives us the direction how we should say that. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself, he consoled the Sahaba radiallahu anhu. Okay, he himself expresses the condolences for Sahaba radiallahu anhu. So that this hadith is about Salama radiallahu anha. So Abu Salama radiallahu anhu, he passed away, and he, after his passing away, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam articulated these things to Salama, means the wife of Abu Salama radiallahu anhu. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, O Allah, forgive Abu Salama, elevate his status among the people, and look after the family that he left behind. O Lord of the universe, forgive us and him, comfort him in his grave, and lighten his stay. In Arabic, this one is narrated as follows, that says that Allahumma ighfir li Abi Salama, warfa' darajatahu fil mahdiyyin, wafsih lahu fi qabrihi, wanawwir lahu fih, wakhlufhu fi aqibihi. And so this is narrated by Imam Muslim rahimahullah in his book of hadith. So we can say something like this when someone has passed away. Also, we can say something like this, that whenever we are giving condolence, we can tell them about this ayah of Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that give glad tidings to those who persevere patiently, and they say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We can tell them about this ayah so that they can become, they can understand that this is the rule of, and this is the decree of Allah. They should accept it, and they should be, they should be keeping the sabr and withhold the sabr. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam also said that Oh Allah, reward my calamity and replace my loss with a better one. Whenever someone is afflicted with any type of calamity, something has lost, something has missed. Suppose you missed some money, you lost some money, or you lost some of your dear one, then you can say, Allahumma jurni fi musibati wa khlufli bi khayri minha. Allah, reward me for my calamity and replace my loss with a better one. This is a dua Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned. And another dua that says it is Allah's take. When someone has passed away, then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to tell them that inna lillahi ma akhadha wa lahu ma a'ta wa kullu shay'in indahu bi ajalin musamma, or similar type of narration. It happened with, I think, with Fatima radiallahu anha or any other, that they lost their child, and then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to them that to Allah whatever for it is Allah's, means it is belong to Allah whatever Allah has taken, and also it is belong to Allah whatever we have, whatever we Allah has taken, whatever Allah has given, everything belong to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for each of the things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has destined, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed its ending, or its qadr is written, its taqdeer is written, it is in the hand of Allah. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi used to say these things when someone has lost his child. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi he himself has lost his son, Ibrahim radiallahu anhu. And so he said, my eyes are tearful, my heart is full of anguish, but we will say only what pleases our Lord. O Ibrahim, your loss filled us with sorrow. He was uttering these words. And Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, he used to say, every day we are told that so and so has died. One day it will be said, Umar has died. Umar ibn Khattab, he himself said, every day we are told that someone has died, and one day it will be said, Umar has died. Okay, so it will happen with anyone. Or maybe we can say about the saying of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, rahmatullah, these words we can tell them, right? We can tell them whenever someone has passed away. And we can also tell them that about this quote of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. He said, a person who is not separated from Adam by a living father is indeed deep rooted in death. Meaning that whoever has come in this dunya, he will be passing, he will be going to die. So this is the gist of the talk of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. And also we can tell about Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah. He said, Ya ibn Adam, innaka anta ayyam, fa idha dhahaba yawmun dhahaba ba'du. O son of Adam, you are nothing but mere days. You are nothing but mere a collection of days. If a day has passed away, your part has passed away. So this is how we can remind them. Also, we can talk about Imam his student, Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah's student, Malik ibn Dinar. He said, the wedding of the one who fears Allah is the day of judgment. The wedding of the one who fears Allah is the day of judgment. It will be a very gala day for him. Okay. Another thing we can tell them, that sorrow and sadness will increase the rewards. Sorrow and sadness will increase the rewards, okay? Okay, now, another thing, Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah, he said that every painful state will gradually pass away, but the reward will remain, meaning that we are afflicted with something bad, okay? This state of sorrow, it will pass away actually eventually, but if we became we persevered, we made sabr on that state, that reward of sabr will remain. So the sorrow will pass away, the reward will remain. And Ata ibn Abi Muslim, he said that life is full of challenges. He said a believer would not be happy for one complete day. It would not happen that the full day everyone is happy. There is nothing wrong. Okay. So now I'm concluding this books, this final subsection of this chapter, by mentioning two of the acts we should not be doing in the time of someone has passed away. So it is someone you will find that people are sending flowers, okay? So Sheikh has mentioned this is not allowed in Islam. We can't do that. We should be doing, this is actually an imitation of the non-Muslims, to send flowers, or maybe to take the flower to the deceased janaza with the procession of the janaza, or in his house, or in his qabr or grave, which is very prevalent in Bangladesh. You will find people going with the maybe VC's, the vice chancellor's grave, and then they're putting the flower on that one in the day, university day or something like this. So this is not an Islamic manner. Another thing is there are some type of things that whenever they're carrying the janaza, they are playing the Quran tilawat of Quran, okay? It is not also part of Islam, okay? We should not be playing any type of Quran during taking the janaza or other things. This time is, as Sheikh has mentioned, this is an state, should be characterized with the thoughtfulness, with being conscious about death, being do fikr, do humbleness, nothing to announce that someone has passed away. Rather, we should think that I am taking this janaza, I will be taken by others in the following day maybe. So we should think about these things. So alhamdulillah, we have completed this book, a short book actually, regarding the Islamic manners and other things. Alhamdulillah, so we are at the end. Sheikh, in the end, he said that this is very, a short message to all of the Muslims, and he said that we should not be taking these things for granted or take it lightly. We should be good mannered with whoever we are, with our parents, with our friends, with even with the non-Muslims. And at last, Sheikh has said that may Allah protect you, your relatives. This is dua from Sheikh, and may Allah help you obey his orders. May Allah pray upon his, may Allah send the salutation upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then he said, this has written in the hope of receiving your dua. So Shaykh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda rahimahullah has passed away already. He, I think, maybe around 20 years now. I don't remember actually, but he is very contemporary scholar. He's not very far from our era. So he has passed away. We have finished his book, and we had some sort of a spiritual connection with Sheikh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda during this lockdown time. We hope and we pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate his status. May Allah forgive the Sheikh, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our effort of finishing this book and the book of Imam An-Nawawi rahmatullah alayh, the 40 hadith of Imam An-Nawawi. Alhamdulillah, it was a nice time with all of you guys. Hopefully we will be seeing each other face to face, and until then we keep safe inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So we janaza niye jawar shomoy to hocche je kora jabe na bolen je hocche quran tilawat kora jabe na.